Rockford Arena on the campus of Illinois State University. The Keith Country Day Lady Cooters battling Stewardson-Strasburg for the Class 1A Championship. Hello, everybody. Alongside Michigan standout Michelle McMahon, I'm Kara Lentz, and today will be the first of four finals we're going to bring to you here on the Comcast Sportsnet. Today's featuring Keith Country Day and Stewardson-Strasburg. Let's take a look at how these teams advanced to today's finals. Keith Country Day actually had to battle it out in three sets against West Prairie, who actually just finished third in the game before this, and Stewardson-Strasburg defeating New Athens yesterday in two sets, and they were led by Kendall Canope, a standout for this team. And Danielle Lampert, and we're coming back to here. And speaking of Keith Country Day, a standout for that team, one of their heavy hitters, also a Michigan recruit for next year, is Adasia Lampert.
Adasia Lampert, an extremely athletic player, and I think she does an outstanding job of seeing the block. And she's athletic and physical, so she brings that presence to the overall court. Just an outstanding athlete for this Keith Country Day team, and a great commit for Michigan.
And Stewardson-Strasburg's Kendall Canope had an absolute dominant day yesterday, 10 kills and a true force for the Comets.
And just standing at 5'6", she uses her athleticism to see the court well, and I like the way that she utilizes her shots on the court, and just a fun player to watch. I always root for the shorter girls because I'm only 5'5".
A lot coming up here in Comcast Sportsnet for a state championship Saturday. Make sure to come on right after this. The Class 1A finals coming right up. Morning and good day from Redbird Arena in Bloomington, Illinois. Keith Country Day set to take Stewardson-Strasburg for the Class 1A Finals. Adasia Lampert, number 25 for Keith Country Day, a senior on this team and a heavy hitter. Michelle, if you're looking at Keith Country Day, what are some keys that they're going to have today?
Well, certainly their seniors are a key, and them stepping up and setting the tone for their offense, but also running a balanced offense. They don't want to be too one-dimensional on the outside. And, of course, for Sue Strauss, their key to victory is that first ball contact and their serving to get Keith Country Day out of system. And speaking of which, Keith Country Day leads with the first point.
Keith Country Day, and Marissa Morgan, number 8, will be serving. Had a dominant performance yesterday all around. Set on the outside to Kendall Canope. Lampert coming down with the hammer. Lampert registers her first kill of the match, number 25.
And there we see her right off the bat, the 6'2" senior. Watch her physicality. She just jumps right up there and slams that ball down. What a great athlete up in the front row.
Adasia Lampert, a 6'2 outside hitter, and has been, quote, a key player for this team. Set on the opposite side, blocked there at the net by Keith. Bailey Quass sends it over. Marissa Morgan sets on the outside of Lampert. Lampert looking for that back row, dug out nicely by the Comets. And Keith not able to handle it on the outside. Another point awarded to Sue Strauss.
Just a nice team effort there overall with a little bit of a communication lapse in the setting there on the second play, but nice job of finishing that last point.
McGarry laying it out in the four. Set on the outside is Brittany Tabbert. Lampert again gets between the double block, and Lampert starting things off strong.
And what I like about Lampert is that not only is she physical, but she uses her athleticism on the outside. She pulls off the net, gets that big approach to the ball, and elevates well to smash that right past the block. And an ace for the senior, Lampert.
Lampert not only contributing with her offense at the net, but also serving.
Absolutely, and that's a key for a six rotation player. She has to be able to execute at the service line, and she's doing just that.
Miscommunication by the Comets, are able to get it over. Hit from the outside, dug up nicely. And Becca Schlechte
And I like that play by Becca Schlechte. She's in the front row. She's aggressive. And she just dumps it over, keeping the defense on their toes. The advantage to that is it pulls a blocker on the offense.
McGarry passes to Morgan on the inside, a little off. Cross to the outside for Brittany Tabbert, looking for the cross court. Alex Nunez digs it up. Quast again. Nunez to Tabbert. Tabbert going straight down the line, and Tabbert registers her first kill of the day.
Amon McGarry does a great job of utilizing her shots. I like the way she's facing cross court, so the defense lines up that way. She just at the last second flicks her wrist and swipes it down the line. A great shot from the junior outside hitter.
Rhonda Schlechte, the head coach for Stu Strauss. In the comments, she's in her third year with a 64-50 record, and this is their first appearance for the Comets under Schlechte. Morgan to McGarry. Set on the outside is Brittany Tabbert. Diving effort by Morgan, not able to connect though, so a point will go to Stu Strauss.
Just a little bit of a footwork lapse there on Lambert. Needs to get her body behind that ball to keep that play, that first ball contact elevated for Marissa to get to. But just a nice play there by Stu Strauss in executing that back row attack.
Morgan looking for and a kill coming out of the front row for Stu Strauss.
And there we see Tabbert on the outside. The senior outside hitter doing a nice job with her footwork and splitting that block. Nice work there by Stu Strauss.
Tabbert having 9 kills and 6 digs yesterday. The senior helping the Comets make it to the finals today.
Amon McGarry just a little bit long in that shot, but I like what she's doing there on that line attack. She does a nice job executing that shot. I'd like to see her continue to go after that shot.
So Stu Strauss has been able to climb back in this set. It's all tied at 5 apiece. Quick set for Danielle Coleman, who gets her first kill.
And that's what I'd like to see more out of on both sides. I think they need to get their middles involved because it comes too reliant on that high ball to the outside. But a lot of that comes down to the first ball contact and controlling the serve receive.
Danielle Coleman, a 5'9 senior, works extremely well with Marissa Morgan.
And another middle play there for Clara Kaufman out of the middle. You see the advantage of running your middles. It's a quicker ball off the set. The defense on the flip side is not ready for that attack and are there caught on their heels, not ready to take that defensive play, but a great job of executing there for Stu Strauss.
Brittany Tabbert digs it up, set on the outside. Is Kendall Canote, but at the net there for the block is Keith.
Danielle Coleman doing a nice job reacting back to that play, keeping an eye, tracking her hitter all the way through the play. Outstanding execution on the block.
Amon McGarry, the 5'11 junior outside hitter for the serve. Kendall Canope. Morgan sets Tabbert. Lampert. And Lampert for the kill.
Lampert, we see the angle she's already hitting. She's hit in front of the 10-foot line. Sharp cross court. I'd like to see a crushed line shot next.
Lampert, an extremely athletic individual. She blocks and scores for Keith Country. Lampert coming up again, looking for that cross court.
And what a great set there by Marissa Morgan, putting Lambert one-on-one, a dangerous situation for Stu Strauss, but a great set. You see she jump sets, fools the block on the other side, and then there's Lambert unleashing on the one-on-one situation.
Set is Bailey Quast. At the net there is Lampert and Coleman. Alex Nunez passes. Lampert again looking for that cross court. Diving effort by the Comets. But again, Lampert coming up with a point.
And that's another key shot for her is using that block. Stu Strauss is a little bit of a shorter team. But for Lambert to use the tips of the blocker's fingers to hit that high ball over the defense's head is an outstanding shot for her.
Served by Iman McGarry. Her sister plays at Purdue, was on the state championship team last year, Keith Countryday winning that 2012 title.
And a great shot for Kendall Canope on the outside. The key player we talked about at the beginning of this match, doing a nice job of utilizing those shots and really using the block to her advantage.
Leader in kills and digs on this team. She's received interest from local colleges for both softball and volleyball. And Comet showing some strong defense at the net.
And that was Amon McGarry who just got set, but great blocking execution there by the middle attacker for Stewardson-Strasburg. Morgan Stremming doing a great job of staying disciplined and pressing over the net. And there is an ace for Clara Kaufman, the sophomore middle blocker on Stewardson-Strasburg, standing at 6 feet tall, doing a nice job of utilizing that baseline to her advantage.
Kaufman again with the serve. Marissa Morgan setting Danielle Coleman. Free ball sent over. Morgan, opposite side to Lampert. Comets keep it up.
And there she is again. Kendall Canope utilizing that block. They call that a tool, and that was off of the middle blocker, Danielle Coleman. But I like the way Canope was attacking those hands across the net. That's what she does well as a shorter player in the front row, utilizing that block on the other side to her advantage. And there's Lambert again, utilizing that physicality, jumping over the block, hitting every angle on the court as we've seen so far tonight.
Entering this match, Adeja Lampert had 235 kills on the season, 111 digs. She led all hitters on the floor yesterday against West Prairie with 15 kills. De La Croix sends it over. Danielle Coleman, Morgan setting to Lampert. Nicely blocked at the net by Quas. Comet send it back. Morgan again to Lampert. She's going to try. And Lampert coming in strong off the outside.
Looks like that one just caught the edge of the pin there. We'll look at the replay and see. Going for that line shot, which I like. That was I was looking for earlier, but just clips the pin attack on that. And Stewardson-Strasburg really needs to start keying in on Lambert. They're leaving her one-on-one too often, and that's just too dangerous of a situation when you have a 6'2" attacker on the outside unleashing.
Alex Nunez into the match for Keith Countryday, as well as Ali Nicolosi, who had a pretty strong performance yesterday against West Prairie, the 5'10 senior. Set on the outside is Becca Schlechte. And Becca Schlechte, a freshman on this team, a 5'8 freshman, her mother, of course, being Rhonda Schlechte. She had 8 assists against New Athens in yesterday's semifinal match, as well as 4 kills. Set straight over the middle is Nicolosi, and Nicolosi coming in strong off the bench.
And I like the combination that Keith Countryday runs on that great setting choice by Marissa Morgan, bringing her middle in for the quick attack, fools the Stewardson-Strasburg blockers, and then brings the right side hitter in for that high middle ball, and she does a nice job of executing that wide open middle shot.
So a point will be awarded to Keith Countryday.
Looks like it's a double contact on that one. Anytime that there's a rotation on out of the set on the ball, you see it rotating multiple times, that's often an indicator of a double hit.
Adeja Lampert, strong serve. Set on the outside and double block going up for Keith Countryday.
Ali Nicolosi doing a nice job of establishing the block early, allowing middle blocker Morgan Luther to close to her and have 4 strong hands pressing across that net.
So Keith Countryday starting to open up a little bit of a lead here. Into the net goes Lampert serve.
Just looked like her toss was a little bit too far in front of her. Dropped that shoulder a little bit, erring into the net.
Morgan setting Nicolosi. Alex Nunez diving for that ball.
And a great block there for Clara Kaufman, staying disciplined in the middle, tracking her hitter all the way through the play, pressing both hands over the net. Great blocking footwork and execution.
Alex Nunez, free ball sent over. Quas setting on the outside. Tipped over the net. Nunez again. McGarry looking for that cross court, and Keith Country Day having a lot of success finding that.
And a great set there by Nunez, but even a better execution by McGarry, because that is a tough ball to hit. When that angle is coming from your libero beyond the 10-foot line, she adjusts her approach, slows down her footwork just a little bit to adjust to the set, and does a nice job executing around the block.
Brittany Tabbert trying to get a touch on it. Becca Schlechte to Tabbert. And Morgan and Nicolosi stuffs it straight at the net.
And Coleman does a nice job of pressing over. That's a key for her this set, to continue blocking well and adjusting that footwork. She's very quick in the middle, and that's where she brings her strong points to the front row for Keith Country Day.
Quas. Quas. To Becca Schlechte.
Just wide for Becca Schlechte. But a great block for Keith Country Day.
So going into this timeout, Keith Country Day a 4-point lead in the Class 1A finals. Glad to have you here alongside Michelle McMahon. I'm Kara Lentz. Plenty of championships coming your way on Comcast Sportsnet, beginning this morning with the Class 1A final between Keith Country Day and Stewardson-Strasburg. Keith Country Day out to a 4-point lead early in the match. McGarry looking for that cross court. And Keith Country Day continues to push this lead. They are up by 5 points. McGarry with 2 kills so far in the match.
And Amaa McGarry is a shot queen. I love the angles that she's bringing. We saw her earlier hit that deep line shot. The defense adjusts to that, and then she fools them cross with that deep cross court shot. Such an important shot to have for the outside hitter.
Miscommunication there coming from Keith Country Day. So Stewardson-Strasburg and Becca Schlechte will be serving.
And I'm impressed by Becca Schlechte so far, just a freshman, doing an outstanding job of really anchoring this Stewart-Strasburg team.
Schlechte passes to Quas. Quas setting on the outside. Brittany Lampert, Quas again. Danielle Coleman, Marissa Morgan, setting alley. Nicolosi coming down with the hammer on the right side.
Great setting choice by Marissa Morgan. And Nicolosi doing an excellent job of executing on the one-on-one situation. She sees that the block is fooled on that middle attacker, and she just rifles it down the line. Props to Coleman for holding that block in the middle.
Schlechte tries to set Tabbert, but right there on the block is Coleman and McGarry.
And McGarry doing a nice job of establishing that block early, allowing Coleman to close out to her, and just an outstanding execution overall.
Allie Nicolosi serving for Keith Country Day. Tabbert passes to Schlechte. Kept alive by Lampert. McGarry, free ball over. Quas, Tabbert, looking for the backcourt. Lampert there. McGarry again from the left side. Allie Nicolosi, Morgan setting McGarry straight over the middle. Comet stuffed that one right in the middle. McGarry again for that cross court. A long rally point here for both teams. Brittany Tabbert. And a point for Keith Country Day after a long rally set.
Great defense on both sides. Their players are doing a nice job in the backcourt of really tracking the ball and running it down, putting their setters in a great position. And there we see head coach Lynn Cesario, who played at Savannah State University 5 years at Keith Country Day. Just an outstanding coach for this Lady Cougar team.
Lynn Cesario, her third state appearance in 6 years, the second under Lynn Cesario, her fifth season with 130-52 record. And Lynn Cesario's team getting things started here.
And Brittany Tabbert rifles it down the line, doing a nice job of seeing that opening that the Keith Country Day blockers gave to her down the line, does a great job executing. And I think that's what she was going for a couple points before when she hit the pin, but doing a nice job executing there.
Danielle Coleman trying to come in strong there. Marissa Morgan sends it over. Quast looking to connect, but right there at the net is Marissa Morgan, a player that seems to be everywhere on the court.
Marissa Morgan standing at 5'8", doing a nice job of really pressing those fingers over the net and not giving Stewardson any opportunity to put that ball away.
So a timeout called. Keith Country Day leads 23-16. And looking at how some of these teams have fared in the state tournament, Stewardson-Strasburg, its best most recent appearance in the tournament, they placed third in 1995. And this is Rhonda Schlechte's first time to the state final, as we said. Assistant coaches be Diane Jack, Nick Harkey, Tammy Manhart. Part of that coaching staff, Tammy Manhart, going on to play collegiately at Michigan State. And Diane Jack, she was made it to the Sweet 16 when she was a senior on that Stewardson-Strasburg team and has been coaching periodically for the Comets since 1982. Plenty of students here for the Illinois State Championship. Redbird Arena, plenty of colors, plenty of pom-poms, plenty of signs, plenty of spirit.
Just a fun time of the year, especially when you have that student support. Travel all the way out here to support your team. Just an outstanding memory for these girls to have. And a kill for Danielle Coleman up at the net. One of the fundamental responsibilities of the middle blockers in the front row is to anticipate those overpasses. And that was McGarry doing a nice job of setting that play up for her with a tough serve in the backfield.
Tough serve coming from McGarry.
Looks like it was just wide there. Got a little too aggressive after the first almost ace.
Well, and Keith Country Day having some very aggressive servers, another one being a Deja Lampert, but strong overall in that category.
And that's something that Stu Strauss has been struggling with, and that's a key to their victory is that first ball contact. So Keith Country Day bringing that heat from the service line is really putting Stu Strauss in a difficult position right now because they're playing their best volleyball when they're controlling the first ball contact.
Controlling the ball for Lampert was Marissa Morgan trying to set on the outside, but a point will be awarded to the Comets.
Comets doing a nice job right now of controlling that serve and pass battle, as I was just talking about, at the service line, getting Keith Country Day out of system to take their key guns out of the offense. And Marissa Morgan with the dump. Great play for the setter. She figures, why not do it herself? Great dump play there for the senior setter.
And Keith Country Day takes the first set, 25-18. It's Championship Saturday. Class 1A finals coming up for the second set right after this. The 6'2 senior Adasia Lampert would like nothing more than close out for her high school career with her second state championship. She leads all hitters on the courts today with 7 kills, 15 assists. So Lampert is standout for Keith Country Day, finding a lot of success. How does Stu Strauss handle Lampert?
Well, as we mentioned earlier, it's controlling the serve and pass battle. Their first ball contact on the serve receive ball is so important to put their setter in the best position to run their offense. Having all three hitters available every time is very key for the Stu Strauss.
So Marissa Morgan will get things started in the second set of the Class 1A finals. Brittany Tabbert hits it into the net.
Looks like she just dropped her elbow there on that play, but it was a pretty low set in her defense. But another key for Stu Strauss is to limit those errors because it is a very slim margin of error with Keith Country Day because they are sound on all fundamentals.
Dug up by Alex Nunez. Marissa Morgan setting Lampert on the outside. Lampert looking for the cross court.
Lampert doing a nice job of trying to weather that set. It was just a little bit too far outside the pin. Looked like it might have caught the line there, but just a little bit wide for the senior outside hitter.
Nunez again, Morgan, McGarry sends it over. And McGarry with a great strike on the ball.
And just an outstanding play for McGarry to not only get the kill, but also make a smart play on that ball. Instead of going for that kill shot, she just rolls it over, doing a nice job of catching the defense off guard, keeping that ball in play. Another key for Keith Country Day.
McGarry had three kills in the first set for Keith. An aggressive serve coming from Lampert in a service ace for the senior.
And that is one of the advantages of the jump topspin serve, as we see that ball looks like it was going out in the last second. That topspin generates that last minute hook and drop on the ball.
Lampert again serving, this time into the net.
Just a little bit of a low toss there for the senior outside hitter. Needs to keep that ball high and keep that elbow up. Because at Michigan, I know Lisa Rosen will be telling her that day in and day out.
Throughout the day, you're going to see plenty of athletes that are going to continue their playing career at the D1, D2, D3 level and junior college level.
Excellent job by Kendall Knope at the service line. We see what happens when we get Keith Country Day out of system. When you bring Marissa Morgan back to the 10-foot line, you take away those guns on the offense. Just a little bit long there for Knope. But a great run so far.
Knope, the 5'6 junior, her coach says that she has been having an absolutely amazing year. And this player still has 1 year to go under head coach Rhonda Schlechte. And speaking of Schlechte, Becca Schlechte hits that one out of bounds.
Just a little bit wide, almost took out a couple victims on the sideline there, but
plenty of photographers that are in prime real estate for getting involved with the action. Quast setting Tabbert. Lampert digs it out of the back row. Morgan sends it over to the outside. Tabbert again looking for the tip. Hits the net instead. Brittany Tabbert not exactly able to get into the rhythm that we saw her yesterday when they were playing New Athens.
And I'd like to see Tabbert just take a couple of breaths, maintain. She's such a great player on the outside. She needs to slow the ball down, slow the play down, and just level out those emotions. You can see the intensity starting to get to her a little bit. Take it one step at a time.
Now, is that something that you individually do as a player, or when you gather as a team, is there some communication?
Absolutely. I mean, in these pressure-filled moments, you're in the state championship game, your emotions are riled up high, and that teammate support is important, but it's also equally important for the individual to really mentally refocus each point, because volleyball is such a momentum point, or momentum game, that it's every point matters. And we see on the outside, Stewardson-Strasburg doing a nice job of executing that. Becca Schlechte on the right side, the freshman.
Couple Comets players trying to dive for that ball. No one able to come up with it. So Keith Country Day pushes their lead here in the second set. They took the first set, and they lead here in the second, 8-4.
And that's Ackerman with the serve. Back out to Tabbert. And a net violation there on Keith Country Day. But Tabbert doing a nice job of just getting back into the flow of things, keeping the ball in play, hitting that deep cross-court shot, setting her team up for the unforced error. And the freshman setter back to serve.
Danielle Morgan coming over strong on that quick set.
And Danielle Coleman with the finish. Something I'd like to watch more and more is that middle involvement in an excellent set by Marissa Morgan. She jump sets up at the net, puts Coleman on a no block situation. Outstanding play for Keith Country Day.
Coleman just coming in with so much power when she's on this court. Brings a lot to this offense, and again, working extremely well with Marissa Morgan, her setter.
And Amon McGarry doing a nice job at the service line with that jump float serve. We talked about the jump topspin serve with Lambert earlier, and Amon McGarry is a great example of the jump float serve, because it's a very unpredictable ball. And as a defensive specialist myself, my least favorite ball to pass. But I think the keys moving forward is Keith Country Day to continue playing to their strong points, keeping the ball in their three-hitter system, allowing Marissa Morgan to run that offense. We see how good she is at running all three of her hitters. The passers need to continue to let her run those hitters. And for Stu Strauss, I think it's just a matter of weathering their emotions, not getting too high on the highs, not getting too low on the lows, and really just even keeling and controlling the serve and pass battle is the key for Stu Strauss, as they are not as physical in the front line as Keith Country Day is.
Keith Country's Day's mottos this season has been to, quote, respect our opponent, coming from Lynn Cesaro, and they have fun, they play best, and that usually is a good equation. And also a team that is extremely focused, and if you remember from yesterday, they took the first game against West Prairie, dropped the second, so it's important for Lynn Cesario and her team that they continue to push this lead if they want to go back-to-back state champs. Brittany Tabbert from the outside. Brittany Tabbert getting the kill.
Tabbert with a great job of executing. That deep cross-court perimeter shot is so key, especially at the high school level, because there's no defenseman there prepared for that shot. Tabbert doing a nice job getting back in her rhythm, executing that shot.
Tabbert with three kills so far in the match. Morgan to Danielle Coleman.
Stu Strauss off to a little bit of a hot streak here, starting with the service line, with Tabbert doing a nice job of getting Keith Country Day in trouble on their serve-receive first ball contact.
Dug out by Alex Nunez. Morgan looking for Coleman, but some miscommunication there coming from the middle hitter.
And Nunez got to be a little frustrated on that play, because that was a perfect 3.0 pass, a 3.0 pass being that Marissa Morgan has all three attack options.
Free ball sent over for the Comets. Brittany Tabbert. Morgan set over the middle is McGarry. McGarry hits it into the net, though.
Amon McGarry doing a nice job coming at all angles. Just looked like she dropped her elbow at the last second there. But I like Marissa Morgan's setting choice of utilizing the back row attack. You can see there was only one blocker up on that. Just another element and dynamic to her offense.
Morgan sets on the outside to Lampert. Haven't seen much of her so far in this second set. A point given to Stusseras, and they tie it up at 10 apiece in the second set of the state final. Brittany Tabbert will be serving for the Comets. Nunez to Morgan. Coleman sends it over. Tabbert digs it up. And a hard kill coming from Kendall Canope, the 5'6 junior outside hitter. Who says size doesn't matter?
Just a little fireball on the outside. Look at how she splits that block. And a great set out to the outside. But really, Canope doing a nice job of utilizing her athleticism, seeing the block.
All right, we're Stu Strauss, a one-point lead in set two. Come on back later, right after this. Kendall Canope has six kills so far in this match. She has helped the Comets come back in this game. The Comets lead 11-10 in set two. Of course, Keith Country Day taking set one. Adesia Lampert set on the outside, dug out by the Comets. Free ball sent over. Nunez to Morgan to Lampert, coming up strong, looking for the tip over. Dug out nicely by the Comets, and a free ball sent back over. Nunez looking for Lampert on the outside. And just off the line after some nice passing and sets coming from Keith Country Day.
And we can see the emotion settling in on Keith Country Day, just fizzling out a little bit. They need to refocus, come back together as a team after every point. But on the flip side of that, Tabbert doing an excellent job of getting them out of system. We see Marissa Morgan bump setting there, but Lambert doing a nice job nonetheless on as a physical outside.
Lampert coming down hard with a great kill again through that double block and finding that backcourt. Gonna have a lot to see from this player as she continues her career for the Maize and Blue. Coleman digs it out. Lampert again set on the side. And Lampert, her second kill, back-to-back points for Lampert.
And at this point, we can see that she's so physical and athletic with her vertical. She's swinging over the block right now. So she can really hit you at any angle, and that's frustrating for the defense because the first line of defense is the block, and when she's hitting over the block, what do?
9 kills so far on the day with Lampert leading all hitters on the floor. Dug out in the back row by McGarry.
Great defensive pursuit by Riley Wernstein.
Free ball sent over for the Comets. Quas setting opposite side.
And it looks like it was 4 contacts for the Comets. Looks like that ball never crossed the plane of the net. Thus, the 4 contact play, and Coleman back to serve.
Danielle Coleman, number 3, serving for Keith Country Day. Set on the opposite side for Bailey Quast.
And another attack error there for the Comets. We can feel the emotion riding high here in Redbird Arena. It's getting exciting here as Keith Country Day begins to pull apart in this state final.
Keith Country Day very used to being in this position. They won the 2012 state finals last year.
Excellent blocking pursuit on the outside for the senior, Marissa Morgan. Doing a nice job of establishing that block, lining up right on the hitter's shoulders and penetrating across the net. Danielle Coleman with the serve.
Coleman sending tipped over, and the Comets try to keep it alive.
And Morgan Luther with the tip on that play. Smart choice for the middle attacker to drop that ball in. And a lot of people wonder sometimes when an attacker goes up and just drops it over the net, the key to that play is to draw the defense in. You want to hit them deep and then drop it short to keep the defense on their toes.
Tampered set a long ball to Kendall Canote. And a point will go for the Comets. So Stu Strauss pulls within 3 points here in set 2. Alex Nunez into the match for Keith. Dug out nicely by Lampert. Morgan, a quick set over the middle. Mishandled by the Comets. Play at the net. And a point will go to Keith.
I really like that serve, though, by Claire Kaufman. An excellent jump float serve. Just a great execution by Keith Country Day.
And Rhonda Schlechte will call a timeout for her Lady Comets. So we're going to take a timeout, too. 17-13, set 2 of the Class 1 state finals. Come right on back here to Redbird Arena. We're back here at Redbird Arena. Set 2 of the Class 1-8 state finals. Keith Country Day taking the first set. The defending state champions in the state of Illinois. Led by a couple heavy hitters up front. And Marissa Morgan, who has 14 assists on the day, as well as 8 digs. Lampert's going to continue to do what this player is able to do.
Just an excellent pursuit on the outside. Her wingspan and her footwork is extremely impressive to me for the senior outside.
When you look at the development with some other high school players in regards to their play, how does Lampert compare? Just how good is she?
I mean, she's raw talent. I mean, she's extremely athletic, but she also executes those fundamentals on the footwork. I would like to see her just improve a little bit on the footwork, just getting a little bit quicker off the net. But as we see, she's so athletic and so physical, she adjusts well to really any situation.
And Lampert is all smiles and sparkles today, wearing that red headband, helping Keith Country Day now to a 6-point lead in set 2, looking for their back-to-back state titles under head coach Lynn Cesario. Lampert on the outside. Schlechte keeps it up. Tipped over. But a point awarded to the Comets.
And it'll be Bailey Quast back to serve, the senior.
Morgan setting Allie Nicolosi coming down for the kill. The 5'10 senior
And I like this combination that Marissa Morgan's running. She's pulling her middle behind on that slide attack, bringing Nicolosi to the middle high ball, putting her on a one-on-one situation. Nicolosi doing a nice job of hitting right outside that blocker shoulder.
Nicolosi goes to the bench. Alex Nunez, the DS, in. And Becca Schlechte looking for a hit down the line.
I like that aggression, though, from the freshman, just going after that shot. Unafraid in this very big situation for just the freshman outside. I like the aggression there. I think they need to continue to be aggressive.
Becca Schlechte had a lot of opportunities in yesterday's match against New Athens. Hard to believe that this player still has three more years to compete for her mom. McGarry, free ball sent over. Schlechte coming from the opposite side. Keeps it alive. Nunez, free ball over. On the outside set, Kendall Canope towards the back row.
Kendall Canope doing an excellent job on the outside. Keith Country Day's block was just a little bit late. Canope sees that and rifles it outside that right shoulder of Keith Country Day's block, doing a nice job executing that cut shot.
McGarry coming up high, the block at the net for the Comets. Schlechte, one of them. And again, looking for that cross court, dug out by Tabbert. McGarry tries to get a touch on it, and the Comets continue to roll here. Later parts of the second set, they only trail five.
And Tabbert does a really nice job of utilizing those blockers' hands. But really for Stewardson-Strasburg, we see the point proven. Volleyball is a momentum sport. They need to continue to ride this high streak and continue to control the ball and get Keith Country Day out of system.
And McGarry coming from the outside for the point. Danielle Coleman re-enters the game. McGarry, very much a volleyball family. Sister plays at Purdue. A junior outside hitter. Marissa Morgan. Quast sets Tabbert. Morgan again to McGarry. That's been working a couple times. Why not go to it again? McGarry with another kill.
And McGarry has just been impressive all day long, doing a great job of executing all those shots. Earlier we saw her drop it in short through the block. There we see that key line shot that she's really owned as her own.
Head coach Lynn Cesario must be happy with McGarry's performance so far, having six kills. And a quick set again from Morgan to Coleman. An excellent defensive effort by the Comets. But Keith comes away with the point.
And props to libero Sarah Locke on Stewardson-Strasburg, doing a great job of running that ball down, trying to spark some sort of momentum here for her team.
Set point and match point for Keith Country Day. Lampert tries to dig it out. Comets able to fend off a set point for Keith Country. 24-17. Keith Country Day looking for their second straight state championships in the state of Illinois. And what a better person to come in from than Adasia Lampert. Finishing with 11 kills on the day for Lampert. Keith Country Day, your 2012 state champions and your 2013 state champions in the 1A class. A lot of celebration going around for the Lady Cougars. Make sure to come back right after this for plenty of awards and interviews. Keith Country Day does it in fine fashion for the second straight year. You're back-to-back state champions in the Class 1A Finals. And Michelle McMahon standing by with their head coach, Lynn Cesario. Michelle?
Once again, ladies.
All right, coach, take me through the season. What has been so special about this team?
Well, it was the same team that we had last year coming back. And it's a great group of girls that have been together for a long time and have built a great togetherness or community, whatever you want to call it.
Tell, Take me through a couple of your seniors. What has been their impact on this season so far on this team?
Oh, wow. Deja has come in, and she's done a great job, been a great team player. You know, it was a big thing for us to get over last year. Danielle Coleman is a very strong but a small middle, has done a great job. My setter, Marissa Morgan, runs our offense and has for 4 years and has done an amazing job, as well as, you know, my other seniors. So,
well, congrats, Coach. Thanks so much for taking the time.
Thank you.
Lynn Cesario completes her season with a 39-3 record. State championship in 2012, state championship in 2013. And a couple seniors on this team that have been a huge impact, including Deja Lampert. Michelle alongside the team's high scorer. Michelle?
All right, Deja. Take me through this season. What has this been like for you as a senior to ride through the trials of this team?
I mean, it's been awesome. I mean, the experience with this team, I couldn't ask for more. I mean, I love this team. My senior year couldn't end better, so I'm glad.
Well, looking forward to Michigan after this. Talk about your decision and deciding to commit to Michigan and what it's been like for you so far.
My decision to Michigan, it was, I don't know, I mean, the coach and the teammates, they are just awesome, and I love it. So.
Well, great. Congratulations, and thanks so much for taking the time.
Thank you.
And Deja Lampert, a standout outside hitter for this team, a 6'2 senior, finished with 11 kills in the match. She got things started early, and she definitely kept that momentum going through the match. Taking a look at some highlights, Lampert, again with 11 kills, striking strong from the outside. She was able to hit the cross court. She was able to hit down line. She was really able to find momentum alongside her teammate, Ema McGarry. Keith Country Day absolutely dominated offensively, but Stewardson-Strasburg came along in that second set, starting to take some of Keith Country Day out of their rhythm. Becca Schlechte and Kendall Canope producing for the Comets, but again, can't really stop the power that some of the players that Keith Country Day possesses. So, Keith Country Day closes it out. Deja Lampert, standout senior, looking forward to starting her career next year at the University of Michigan. And we'll be back in a little bit for trophies, awards, smiles, and so much more. Stick around, it's Championship Saturday here on Comcast SportsNet. Decided. And Keith Country Day taking the championship with that. Your runners-up, Stewardson-Strasburg. And we'll hand it over now to the awards and public addresser.
Athletic Director Nick Niemerg. Head Coach Rhonda Schlechte. Assistant Coach Diane Jack. assistant coach Nick Hartke, assistant coach Tammy Manhart. Now let's say hello to the Comets players, the freshman Olivia Grotz, sophomore Jill Conder, senior Sarah Locke, freshman Becca Selecti, senior Morgan Strimming, senior Brittany Tabbert, junior Kendall Knope, senior Lindsay Burton, sophomore Clara Kaufman, senior Bailey Quost, manager junior Skylar Vanderhyde, video tech junior Christina Bites, and manager freshman Casey Garrett. And now will Coach Rhonda Schlechte and the captains of the Comets please step forward to receive your second place trophy. Ladies and gentlemen, the Comets of Stewardson-Strasburg! And now at this time, put your hands together, raise the roof. Let's meet the Lady Cougars of Rockford, Key Country Day, your state champions. The 2013 first place winners in a final record of 39 wins, 3 losses. First meet the superintendent of Keith Country Day, the Lady Cougars, Dr. Deb Dimke. Head of upper school, Dr. Ron Lee. Athletic director, Robert Nunez. And the head coach of the Cougars, Lynn Cesario! Assistant coaches, Tim Keating and Alyssa Tomei. Put your hands together. Here come the players for the Lady Cougars, the junior Alexandria Nunez. Senior number 3, Danielle Coleman. Sophomore, Riley Wurstein. Senior, Keely Johnson. Senior, Marissa Morgan. Senior, Allison Ackerman. Sophomore Laura De Rosales. Sophomore Kirsten Edgerston. Kirsten Edgerston. Freshman Erica Hinchin. Senior Vanessa Schubert. Junior Amon McGarry. Senior Morgan Luther. Senior Ali Nicolosi. Freshman Christy Bodak. And senior Adesia Lambert. And now, will head coach Lynn Cesario and the captains of the Lady Cougars please step forward to receive your first place trophy? The champions for the 2013 Girls Volleyball Tournament 1A Volleyball, the Lady Cougars of Rockford Keith Country Day!
Sure to come on back later this afternoon. We'll have your 2A final championships, 3A and 4A, all right here on Comcast SportsNet. Thanks so much. We'll see you in a little bit.